Everybody, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Two running backs will take the field today in hopes of leading their team to victory out on that field. It's the Raiders going up against the Jaguars. Now we'll go down to Jim Nance and Phil Sims for this Week 3 matchup.
The season moving along as we get set for today's Week 3 action.
Hello, friends. Jim Nance along with Phil Sims. And Phil, it's an absolutely gorgeous day here for football. And how will that factor into this game?
It's always a factor, Jim. You have good weather. Now you can call anything you want and not worry about the elements disturbing your game plan. It's a complicated game. There's no doubt about it. But it's less complicated when you have good weather.
Tywan Jones is back deep for the opening kick. The Jaguars setting up here for the kickoff. This game has officially begun. Cooper's got it on the return. He heads to the sidelines, out of bounds, and a run back of about 20. Carr's heading towards the huddle now, having connected on over 70% of his passes last week. First down at the 31. And the catch is made by Rod Streeter.
How about that? We just saw the fly route straight down the field by the receiver. Long throw by the quarterback and a nice completion.
The Jaguars with a nickel look here on defense. Now first and 10. Rod Streeter has the reception. That's a gain of 10.
The drag route is a huge part of every offense now in the NFL. It's where the receiver starts on one side of the football, goes across the field, looking for those spots where he can catch it, and the quarterback that time threw it at the right time, right on target, good yardage, just short of the first down.
Following that completion, second and short.
All right, here we go. Five and eight.
The play clock's running down. Launches it down the field. Mike has it. Touchdown. Phil, what a way to make a statement by scoring so early in this game.
You know, Jim, I love making statements, and that's what this team did. They went out there and told the opposition, we are better, we're tougher, and take that.
no return as this goes for a touchback. Bortles coming out now to get this offense going. He had just one touchdown pass last week. First down at the 20. Could have been intercepted. Here's our look at the Jaguars offense. Last week, they never turned the football over once. Second and 10. Gets the handle here. Lofton's all over the ball carrier. We're early. The first down and a whole lot more.
The Jaguars offensive line will be whooping it up tomorrow when they watch this play in the film room. What a good job by them. Excellent planning and awesome execution.
First down at the 22. Lofton's able to read that play and make the hit.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
Breaking huddle at the 23-yard line. Second down and 11. He will not get away. He's taken down for the sack.
A lot of things to look at if you're a quarterback of this league now, isn't it? You're looking at safeties. You look at linebackers. But you forget, hey, these corners can blitz. Good disguise, good timing, and a nice sack by the corner.
Coming to the line at the 34. The Jaguars will set up. The 12 is the first down line. The Jaguars have it at the 34. And he's sacked again. They've come out of the blocks fairly sluggishly. And this defense has taken full advantage, Phil.
Yeah, the offense having a tough time. They did not have a good series that time. And the defense, you're right, took advantage of a sluggish offense and got off the field.
It'll be a touchback. The Jaguars' defense, let's see where they are mentally here, Phil, after allowing a touchdown.
Well, they got to have some motivation after that last drive that was so poor. It's about discipline. We didn't see it from their defense. So this time, go out there and just do your job.
First down at the 20. And Crabtree's got it on a pass. Had some heat on it.
Jim, they call that a post route. Do you know why? The receiver is running towards the goal post, so they call it a post route.
First down and 10. They'll go ground. Jones all over that offense.
defense and brings him down.
Raiders running back that time, he makes a bad decision. You can't be looking to make every play a big play when you're running the football. Look for a few yards, take advantage of that. He tries for the big play. What happens? He gets tackled for a loss.
Loss of two on that play. The Raiders' offense is still out there as we get the second quarter underway. Second down. Cars lined up, two tight ends set, handoff made. And now they'll be on the other side of the 50 after this play.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
Third down and five. Murray's got the carry once more.
This is called managing the football game as a head coach. What are you doing here? You got a lead. It's close. It's fourth down. It's short yardage. You're near midfield. Don't do it. Punt the football away. And if the other team's going to go ahead, make them drive the length of the field.
Cars back in shotgun formation. It's intercepted. Tackle's made.
Nice job of the defense that time. In position, they read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
The Jaguars bringing their offense onto the field. It wasn't a very productive possession for them last time out, Parker. They ended up punting.
Well, you know what it was? It was a good feeling out process. So they got some knowledge by watching the defense and what defenses they tried on them. So you've got to take advantage of that knowledge and come out here and make some plays. What we're seeing so many times now in this league is the tight ends are getting so good that they have to condense the pass coverage to make sure they stop them, and it's opening up the wide receivers to have a better chance to catch the football.
First down at the 42. They run the counter play.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense that time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
Second down here. They go draw. Rock for a loss on that play.
Well, it doesn't get much worse than this, does it? You're losing the football game. Now you're looking at third and long. And look, there are no miracles in the NFL. I'll tell you that. So be smart. If the play is not there, don't force it. Dump it off and wait for the next time you get it.
Third down now.
There we go, now. 45.
We'll send it back to the quarterback out of the gun. And he's thrown to the ground. Middle of the second quarter, and this offense continues to struggle, Phil.
Sooner or later, they've got to find some rhythm out there. And, you know, maybe it's a trick play that can get them started. Sometimes a reverse, a flea flicker, plays like that can get your offense feeling good and playing better.
And that punt is going out of bounds. They are not going to allow them to return it. The Raiders have impressed today with some of these deep passes. Carr's been showing off that cannon he has for an arm.
Yeah, he's got it all, doesn't he? When you watch him throw the football down the field, you can see the arm strength. But the biggest thing is you can see that wonderful touch on the football. He is laying that football in there right on the money.
First down snap, and this is a scare. Point for them. The Raiders are at the line of scrimmage with a pair of backs split behind the quarterback. And Cooper is able to get hold of it.
Well, he's got his way, and I think his talent, the way offenses are designed, and the rules of the NFL, it makes guys like him almost unstoppable.
Picked off that time. 2 minute warning. We've got a defense out on that field trying to stand tall and keep this deficit as it is on the scoreboard. Second down and 10. He'll throw it over the middle. Almost intercepted that time.
Manage the football game. That's what you have to do as a quarterback. You're winning a close game and it's third and long. Well, manage it. Know what to do. Don't force the play here. If it's not there, throw it away and just punt the football.
Out of the shotgun formation. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down. Timeout's called. We're going to step aside. Be back in just a moment. The defense needed to slow this game down. That timeout might be very useful. Now they're ready to go. The Raiders will go for it here on fourth down and short. Double tight end formation. Out of the gun. Running room. Taken down at the 33. The Raiders roll the dice and pick up the first on fourth down.
Yeah, I like that analogy. Roll the dice. Sometimes you got to take a chance and hope it comes up seven. Well, I don't know about the seven, but they pick up the first down.
Raiders take it from the 33. Running room. Carr's taken down at the 49. Moving it to the other side of the field at the 49. Two tight ends on the field here. First and 10. Unable to find his target that time.
That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position, nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football, and it leads to another incomplete pass.
That's second down coming up. Carr's going to take it from the gun. They're going to get him here for a sack.
Not a good job by the quarterback that time. Inside of 2 minutes in the first half, you got to get rid of the football. If nobody's open, just throw it away. That time, he loses yards by taking the sack.
After that big-time sack, they'll now face 3rd and 17.
Ready, ready, 18.
Carr standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Had it for a moment, but then lost it on the hit.
Crabtree's really hit hard that time. And I know the football hit his hands, but when a defender times it perfectly like that, with that much power and speed going into that receiver, you are going to let that football go. That's human nature. Really good job by the defensive player.
The Raiders elect to go for it and bypass the punt on fourth down.
Ready, fire.
Carr's got it in the gun. Clutch catch.
The Raiders do a really terrific job picking up that fourth down play that time. It gives them an emotional lift. And look at the defense. They are down because they gave it up.
The first half is complete. Larry Ridley is ready to take things over back in our studios. And you're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Thanks, Jim, and welcome to the EA Sports Halftime Report. Now let's get to it. The Raiders played well en route to a victory last week, and today it's been more of the same. The Jaguars are just going to have to try and figure out a way to make a dent in this deficit. All right, let's roll the highlights. Raiders with the football early in the first. Carr's got the completion here, and this goes 36 yards for the score. Raiders with the early advantage. Jaguars have it midway through one. Thomas is going to haul in the deep pass, and the pass and catch will end up going for 36 yards. Raiders have it near the end of one. Crabtree's got the reception, and he won't be brought down until he makes it to their own 46-yard line. Raiders wind up throwing a pick on the drive. So that'll do it for us. We'll send you back down to the field where Jim Nance and Phil Sims are on the call.
All right, Larry, thank you for all of those updates. And now the teams are coming back onto the field, and we're about to get the second half started. The second half is officially underway. Touchback now as the ball comes out to the 20. The Jaguars have put their quarterback in some really tough positions today. Bortles trying to stay upright and make the plays, but it's tough to do so when you're constantly being hit.
Yeah, no matter what you do as a quarterback, though, you can't start looking at the pass rush. You have to keep your focus down the field, and you can't flinch.
Here's the first snap of the second half. Incompletion here as he was looking over the middle.
Quarterbacks love to see a receiver have this type of play. Even though he doesn't make the catch, the effort is outstanding, and he's given everything he has to make that catch.
And 10. The give. That's the one who made the big stop.
Well, I know in a situation like this, here's what you have to do. You have to call. Play that at least gives you a chance to pick up the first down. If it's not there, then you tell the quarterback to throw it.
Bortles ready for the snap. Empty backfield. Third down and 12. On the receiving end, it's Irvin. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down.
And that's a defense that doesn't yield a whole lot. They didn't in the first half. And now, same story here in the third quarter, Phil, especially on third down.
Yeah, been a good job. They've done a good job all day long on third down, Jim. But the defensive coordinator, let's give him some credit. It takes talent and good coaching to make it work on the field. And right now, they're getting some good coaching.
He'll pick up seven this time. The Jaguars defense walks back onto the field. Somewhat inspired, I'm sure, about that last series when they came up with the fourth down play.
Yeah, listen, I agree. Sometimes you're in situations where you need to go for it on fourth down. But that last one, Jim, there was no excuse for that. That was just a horrible decision.
And it's knocked down. Failing to complete that one. So, second down here.
Amari Cooper has the catch.
That's what you want to do. Just get a first down, especially when you're on top. Keep the clock moving. Keep the defense guessing. Make them react instead of attack.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Looking at every option. The ball is taken out of his hands.
That incompletion by the quarterback. Hey, I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player. He's in position and able to make the football be incomplete.
Second down coming up. The Jaguars lined up in the nickel. Carr's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Climbs the ladder, and he has it.
The Raiders offense has been tough today. They are fighting out there on the field. That's a nice job picking up that first down. It's been fun to watch. They got a small lead here in the second half. We'll see if that first down can lead them to a score.
The catch. Touchdown. They're not that far from closing this game out after that touchdown here mid-third quarter.
Yeah, it's unbelievable. It's a dominant performance so far. That drive just set it off. They wanted to take it down the field, execute the plays. They did it, and the defense just let them have their way.
The Jags are ready to return the kick. Touchback. The Jaguars haven't had a very productive drive in quite a while here, Phil. Do they need to switch things up to get this train rolling again?
Absolutely. Switch it up. Switch up the play call. Show some different formations. Try to catch the defense by surprise. If you do that, that's going to greaten your chances of having success.
The Raiders' defense now is going to go nickel. First down at the 20. Throws the pass. Justin Blackmon hauls it in. That's his first reception today.
When you pick up first downs against the defense, they will get tired. That time, nice job by the offense getting the first down, even though they're losing here in the game.
First down at the 41. And it's Curtis Lofton who makes the play.
Ready,
Turtles back in shotgun formation.
I think it's important for the defense. Anytime it's a third and long situation for the offense to know where those first down markers are, give a little ground, and make sure you're able to come up and make the tackle short of the first down marker.
Bortles will be taking this snap out of the pistol. The Jaguars snap it at the 41. On the money.
He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
It's third and long. Nobody open down the field, so the quarterback does the only thing he can do, throw it short.
And so now they'll call on Anger to punt the football. And the punt is kicked out of bounds. The Raiders have done a whale of a job taking their halftime lead and adding a whole lot more to it here in the third quarter.
And they're just doing everything we saw them do in the first half, just dominating the pace of play and just being more physical than the defense.
First down at the 18. Scans the field. Leaps in the air and has it. That's his first reception today. The Raiders have been very good throwing the football today. Carnes continued to be one of the best field generals in the game.
I just love the way he dominates everything with the football team, especially on the offensive side, Jim. We see he's in command of everything, and of course, we see all the great plays he makes.
Back to the air here on first down. There is a flag out. Going to take it home for the touchdown.
Holding. Defense.
Built to climb the penalty and let the play stand. The Raiders for the point after. He made it. The Raiders defense will now be ready to get on the field. Their offense moved the ball over 80 yards on that last drive. Really no answer for them on what was a very impressive drive. Touchback here will bring the ball out to the 20. The Jaguars at this point are just trying to stop the bleeding as they come out for this drive, Phil.
Whoa, I don't know if there's enough band-aids to stop all this bleeding, but look, you're looking for a moral victory, so the game is not over. Try to get some good here late to make you feel better and get ready for the next game.
And Edwards is there to make the tackle.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Second down and two to go after the running play. For this play, they'll go with two tight ends. Here's the handoff. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
They come to the line, and it's first down. We're back, and this game has not been close. The final quarter begins with this snap. Underneath and incomplete that time.
Lots of ways to attack cover two. There's no doubt about it. You can throw it underneath. you can pump fake the safeties, make one of them move, and still throw it deep down the field.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Bortles going to take it from the gun. Thomas got the catch and the first. Thomas is the injured player, and we'll take a break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And welcome back. Danielle Bellini is working on getting us an update on the injury as we return to action. The Jaguars all bunched up here as they get set at the line. Bortles standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Second down coming up. From the gun. And it's a reception by Blackman. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Jim, here in the fourth quarter, when you're down, what you want to do is just keep that football moving. That time it's a short throw, he gets a completion. Good job.
Play number six coming up on this drive. The Jaguars snap it at the 41. Has his man. Finally, a third down conversion.
You know, when you throw the football like that down the field, you pick up a first down, now you can do anything you want on the offensive side, and you've got that defense guessing.
Bortles completion percentage, 60% on the day. First and 10. It's wide open. The ball is fumbled, and the recovery is made by the defense. Were you ever in a game, Phil, where nothing worked all the way to the fourth quarter, and even at that point still giving the football away on fumbles?
Well, unfortunately, Jim, I was involved in some of those games, and I was the main culprit in some of those bad situations. But if I was the coach, and here's what you got to think. When your team plays this way, you got to think about making some changes. That's what you do. Breathe some new life. Get somebody in there to give this team maybe a little more enthusiasm when they play.
The Raiders will take the snap from the 25. Can't hold on here as this goes incomplete.
Got to give this sexing league now. It's hard to make plays, but a good play there and another incomplete pass.
It's now second down.
Here we go.
Carr's got it in the gun.
Lee Smith with the reception.
Tackle's made, and the first down is picked up.
The Raiders know they have one of the best QBs in the league, and it's showing up in the stat sheet these last 2 weeks.
Carr's been doing what makes him so good these past few weeks, and it's really coming as no surprise.
Oh, my gosh. What's it like to be him? Just to know as a quarterback you're going to come into the game, you're going to be hot.
The Raiders are in front thanks to their quarterback. Carr's had a huge performance in this one.
When you talk about creating opportunities, that's where you have to give credit to the coaching staff. They have helped the players. The play designs have been good, and the players are taking advantage of it.
The Raiders have it at the 39. Stands in the pocket. Firing it way down the field. A receiver is there, and he has
the ball deep down the field.
When you can't hit the quarterback or put pressure on him, there's not much you're going to get done then. That time, quarterback had time and throws it down the field for another completion.
Here's the first snap after the big play. Carr's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Picks up about five.
Well, that last play almost got him in here. And when you look at this, what do they do? Well, you just want to punch it in. There's a lot of different scenarios. You could do a play-action fake, probably get somebody wide open, or have a running back just jump over the top for the touchdown.
The next snap will come from the 2-yard line.
Defense ready in the goal line formation on this one.
Reese is another touchdown to increase the lead. It's been over for a long time, Phil, but at least we waited until midway through the fourth quarter to declare it.
Yeah, we've been thinking it for a while, but now we can say it out loud. And look, the losing side, look, you got to go back and think about what you did this game. The strategy, it was all wrong. And if you want to win another game, you better think and change what you're doing.
The Jaguars are back deep, ready to return the kickoff. Harvin on the return. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. The Jaguars' offense has not operated anywhere close to peak performance today, and that's why they're behind in this game in the late going.
Yeah, Jim, they were never sharp. They never made the plays to really get things going, to give them confidence where they can string those plays together and get some scores and just change this game around. They got a lot of work.
And he's intercepted.
Able to show off those great hands and picking off that pass from the linebacker position. What a job and what a pair of hands.
The Raiders offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. That was a solid touchdown drive.
Now just look at them, Jim. The way they run onto the field, you can see they're exuding confidence. When you got a confident football team, man.
Well, I tell you, it's getting ugly out here.
The Raiders for the point after. The point after try is in the books. The Jaguars have been flat out manhandled so far. Perhaps their special teams unit can change the momentum of this one. They need something to go their way. The score's 35-0. Lined up now in kickoff formation. Harvin will try to run this one out. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. The Raiders defense can take a bow for its performance today. They're going to win the game, and it's because of this unit.
Yeah, look, if they want to know how to take a bow, all they have to do is ask you, because you like to take bows whenever you get a chance.
I'll take one right now.
Okay.
The Jaguars have it at the 24.
And it's caught by Allen Burns.
The defense has a lead here in the fourth quarter, Jim, so they're willing to give up those short completions
Now it's up to the defense. Come up, make the tackle. Good job that time.
The Jaguars had to go all out for 60 minutes last week in a victory, and now perhaps it's caught up with them. They've been struggling to stay in this game here, Phil.
No shortcuts in the NFL. They played 60 minutes last week. They are definitely not playing 60 minutes this week. To me, Jim, they look a little tired.
The Jaguars from the 27 makes the reception. He's tackled at the 28.
The defense, they have a lead here in the fourth quarter, so they're willing to give up short pass completions, but good job by the offense.
Third down on the way. Bortles alone in the backfield. From the gun. Interception. That's got to be the game ender here, partner. The interception. As with all turnovers, play is stopped now as the crew wants to confirm whether or not that was, in fact, an interception.
Well, that was an awesome play by the defense that time, getting the interception. Now they turn into receivers once they get the interception. Did he have possession of the football? We'll find out.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
Inside of 2 minutes, so that review came from upstairs. They're just doing their due diligence. That play on the field will stand. It was the right call in the first place.
Yeah, it was the right call, but you know what, too? Now it answers the question to the coaches, to all the people watching the game at home, and the fans in the stadium. The right call was made on the field.
Smith's there to catch a ball that had a lot of heat on it.
Hard to guard these tight ends now in the NFL. It really puts the defense in like a quandary. Do we use a big guy? Well, if the big guy's not fast enough. We use a small guy? Well, he's not big enough. They get pushed around. I don't know what you're going to do. Just make sure you're a good tackler after they catch it.
First down here after the completion. Incomplete. Almost going in the other direction.
Good job that time by the defensive player. He reads the quarterback, gets in position. Down near his own end zone, knocks that pass down.
The ball sits at the 12-yard line. The Jaguars defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. They'll go shotgun here. Scanning the field. And it's swatted away.
Things get tight down here in the red area. I got to give the defensive man a lot of credit, though. In position, sees the ball thrown, and is able to get that hand up there and knock it down.
They bring in the extra tight end. Carrs back in shotgun formation. Smith brings it in for the score in the end zone. Impressive showing today, and it's almost on the brink of running up the score and creating some bad blood. What do you think, Phil?
Oh, who cares, man? Rub it in, baby. Rub it in. When you're on top and you're winning the game, I say go for it. Rub some salt in that wound and let them know how much it hurts.
The Raiders now will tack on the extra point. It's good. Smith's probably ready to get right back on the field after that last drive. A drop. The Jags are ready to return the kick. And here's Harbin. And he's taken down right at about the 29, not quite to the 30. The Jaguars have failed to come away with points on three consecutive drives. Their offense takes the field again now. What's caused them to go silent here, partner?
Listen, let's give all the credit to the defense. They're being very creative on the defensive side. The coach is calling the right plays, and they are just taking it to the offense right now. The more aggressive team is winning, and that's the defense.
The Jaguars have it at the 29. That's going to fall incomplete. Blackman was in the vicinity.
Well, your teammates are really going to respect your yield as an athlete. And when you give all your effort to every single play like that time, how about that? Just giving every bit of effort he can to make the catch, not able to get it. But what a job of effort.
Surveys. Looking long. And they can't connect.
I know his quarterback coach is going to yell at him when he goes to the sideline. When you're throwing the long pass down the field, don't underthrow it like that.
One more snap and we can call it a day. The Jaguars have it at the 29. Down the field. That's an interception. Things are clicking right now, and this team has to feel invincible without a loss on the year.
Oh, you know they do. Just to come into this game, today's game, the other team wants to put that first loss on them so bad, not able to do it because they got outplayed. That's why the team is undefeated.
So for Phil Sims and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nance.